With Paul George requesting a trade out of Oklahoma, it leaves Russell Westbrook in a different situation to how he started off this season. He started off with Paul George, a replacement for Kevin Durant, a guy that honestly could have led this team to the Western Conference Finals if they could have played well and meshed together as a team. And honestly, I still give the Oklahoma City Thunder full credit. Give Westbrook a guy that is similar to Kevin Durant. Obviously, there are not many players similar to Kevin Durant. But to give Westbrook a guy like Paul George as a replacement for Kevin Durant wasn't a bad piece at all. Because obviously Paul George is one of the best two-way players in the league, and whilst it didn't work out, give the Thunder their credit, and now they just have to look to the future. I believe you should always have a winning mentality. The Clippers have proved that, the Heat generally proved that with Pat Riley, I believe the Spurs have proved that, and I believe as a whole, it just helps to be a winning team because you're always in the hunt, number one, for future potential free agents, and number two, because why not try and compete no matter what? It's better than tanking, and especially with the NBA draft order and the change there, it's harder to get a top three pick now. Just ask the Phoenix Suns. That didn't work for them. They were projected to tank, get Zion Williamson or RJ Barrett or someone of the top three, and they didn't get anyone. So what I'm saying is, I believe that the Oklahoma City Thunder and Sam Presti still should have some credit, even just for the past 2 years. And yes, I get it. They didn't click as a team, but at the same time, they tried. And at the end of the day, that's all you can do if you're an NBA team. And obviously, I do understand it's easier for a big market like LA, Miami, Boston, to just be like, yeah, we're going to always compete and we're still going to be an option for future potential free agents. Whereas a small market team like Oklahoma, it's hard for them to do that. But at the same time, you can also have the best of both worlds. Oklahoma, they tried to get Russell Westbrook another star to compete. Now that it didn't work, they are also in a rebuilding phase. So I think there's a time for both scenarios. But at the same time, once you lose Kevin Durant, to be able to get Paul George as a replacement was extremely good. It just didn't work out. Imagine if the Pelicans got someone like Paul George to surround Anthony Davis. I mean, I guess they got DeMarcus Cousins, so they tried. So that was probably a bad example. But how about Paul George in Charlotte to surround Kemba Walker? Or even last season, the LA Lakers getting Paul George to pair up with LeBron James. Like, obviously this is last season. They end up getting Anthony Davis, so it all worked out in the end. But what I'm saying is, at least the Thunder took a risk. That is all I'm saying. That's why I believe the Thunder should still get their credit. I see a lot of people hating on them, and just because it didn't work out, I don't think they deserve it. But why didn't it work out? Why were they eliminated in the first round in both seasons together? In 2018, they were eliminated by the Utah Jazz in 6 games, and this year, obviously, they were eliminated by Portland in 5 games. So there was really never a chance of them even making it to the second round, because in both series, they couldn't even force a game 7. Now, is this the result of Russell Westbrook, or was it the result of Paul George? Because when Westbrook played with Kevin Durant, they were able to make the Western Conference Finals. So, was it the result of Paul George not being able to live up to what Kevin Durant was? Or was it still Russell Westbrook? Let me know down below what you guys think. With that being said, here are 5 NBA trades that could land Russell Westbrook onto a new team. I personally believe that the last 2 are the most realistic and they have the highest chance of actually happening, but I wanted to put 5 teams in here just because why not see what happens? You never know. If the Thunder do not trade Russell Westbrook before the start of the season, new teams will start to emerge. Teams on the cusp of making the playoffs and teams that really want to push for the NBA championship that may not have that extra piece. Russell Westbrook may be that guy. A lot of people hate on Russell Westbrook. I personally don't hate on him. I just think that at times he can stat pad, but I don't think he is a bad player to have on your team. I think he's one of the greatest players in today's NBA, and I do believe that the only concern is his huge contract. In saying that, let's look at 5 teams that Russell Westbrook could end up on. And if you enjoy these types of videos, it would be greatly appreciated if you could subscribe if you're new for daily NBA content and leave a like to support the channel. That would be greatly appreciated. Anyway, let's get into it. At number 5, Russell Westbrook to the Minnesota Timberwolves. Okay, now I don't really believe that this will happen, but I really don't think it's that bad of a trade, to be honest with you. This is Andrew Wiggins, a Jared Culver, and a future first round pick to the Oklahoma City Thunder in exchange for Russell Westbrook. But to be honest with you, out of respect for Russell Westbrook and what he's done for the Thunder, I don't believe they're going to trade him to a team like the Minnesota Timberwolves. I personally believe that they will trade him to a future contending team, which is why I don't believe that this trade will actually go through. What does this do for the Minnesota Timberwolves? Number one, it gives them their point guard. Number two, it gives them a guy that they can pair up with Karl Anthony Towns that isn't named Andrew Wiggins, who obviously that experiment hasn't really worked out too much for the Minnesota Timberwolves. In saying that, it gives the Oklahoma City Thunder a reasonably young player that had the potential at the start of his career and just hasn't lived up to it. But he could still make a transition, in my opinion, to being an all-star caliber player if he puts in the work and finds a team that really supports him and surrounds him with pieces. Andrew Wiggins is still reasonably young, and Jarrett Culver is a really solid piece that I don't think the Oklahoma City Thunder would not mind having on their team. Plus, another first round pick, and they are set for the future. Plus, the contract situation works out because Andrew Wiggins is on a very steep contract, and so is Russell Westbrook. So that is trade number 5. Number 4, Russell Westbrook to the Houston Rockets. Now, this one, do I think it's going to happen? Probably not. In saying that, the duo of Russell Westbrook and James Harden would be so fun to watch because we watched them before in Oklahoma. Now we can watch them in Houston and see what they make of it. In saying that, the Houston Rockets already tried to make a trade for Jimmy Butler. That obviously didn't work out. And considering they didn't really do a whole lot in this year's offseason, they're basically going into next season with the same team that's a little bit older. Chris Paul, PJ Tucker, Eric Gordon, a little bit older. So are they going to play the same as last season? Well, we don't really know. In saying that, I believe the West also got better. The Jazz got a ton better. I believe they'll be a top 4 seed. The Clippers, obviously they got a lot better, and they were already a really decent team. The Lakers obviously got better. So the Rockets, are they going to be as good? Well, that's up for debate. Russell Westbrook and Steven Adams. They go to the Houston Rockets. Clint Capella as a replacement for Steven Adams, as he's on a $15 million contract, whereas Steven Adams is on around $22 million. So that saves a little bit of cap space there. So with Clint Capella being on a cheap contract, it still allows the Thunder to either compete or to continue their rebuild, which they will, even if they get CP3, Eric Gordon, and Clint Capella from the Houston Rockets, plus 3 to 4 future first round picks. That would mean the Thunder have all the picks that they received, all 7 picks that they received from trading Paul George, plus around 3 to 4 future first round picks for trading Russell Westbrook and Steven Adams, which gives them the brightest of futures. Plus, they can still compete with Chris Paul, Eric Gordon, Danilo Gallinari, Jeremy Grant, and Clint Capella. That's still good enough to compete, and you are still able to rebuild from that with some assets that you can trade in the future. Look, at the end of the day, is it going to happen? Probably not. But if you're the Houston Rockets, a Russell Westbrook and James Harden pairing would be insane to watch. Once again, we've watched it before. It'd be so fun to watch again. And it spices up the Houston Rockets a little bit. Russell Westbrook, James Harden, PJ Tucker. They can probably sign a free agent power forward, and they would still have Steven Adams at center, which is a decent core in the Western Conference. Now, like I said, will it happen? Probably not. But just a trade scenario that would be so fun to watch. Number 3, the New York Knicks. Look, if any team was going to miss out on the key free agents of this year's NBA free agency, it was going to be the Knicks. Because they were so ready, so hyped. Everybody believed that they could have got one superstar free agent, and they ended up with nothing. Now, to the Knicks' credit, I don't believe that that's a bad thing, and I'm going to make a separate video talking about the Knicks later on. But I personally don't think that losing out on the key free agents, apart from Julius Randle, is really a bad thing, because I don't believe that there's any point in signing a guy like Kemba Walker, or a guy like DeMarcus Cousins, when they're not good enough to make you championship contenders anyway. Why not build your young core, see how they play, and then go for the 2021 free agency, which is arguably just as stacked. If I'm the Knicks, I'm happy with Julius Randle. I believe he'll be an all-star this season, and I believe that him pairing up with RJ Barrett and you still got Dennis Smith Jr. is not a bad young core. They will still be a future free agency destination. In saying that, if they could get Russell Westbrook on this team to pair up with Julius Randle and RJ Barrett, would that be a good fit? Probably not. But if any team was going to do it, I believe the New York Knicks would do something like this. Just because they're the New York Knicks and they have James Dolan. Is it going to happen? Most likely it will not happen. But you never know with the Knicks. Anything can happen. Number 2, Russell Westbrook to the Orlando Magic. This was a playoff team last year, and they re-signed Nikola Vucevic. They also have other pieces like Aaron Gordon who could take that next step in his development. Plus, they have pieces that the Thunder may actually want. A guy like Jonathan Isaac, who's only 22 years old, and Mo Bamba, who's only 21 years old. These are two very young and raw talents that the Thunder can develop with their young and upcoming pieces like Shai Gilgeous-Alexander and their future picks to actually create a young core that can develop into something in the future. Now, to make the salary work out, I believe that the Magic would probably have to give up somebody, maybe Evan Fournier, who's on a one-year contract, which means he's off the books for the Thunder, which they would take, maybe 2 to 3 first-round picks from the Magic, which could be very interesting. But for the Magic, you would still have a pretty good team because number one, you are in the Eastern Conference, which is pretty wide open at the moment. Number two, Vucevic is an all-star. Aaron Gordon has the potential to improve. Terrence Ross is still a solid player. And you pair that up with Russell Westbrook, and you never know. That team could do something in the Eastern Conference. And number one, and to be honest, the most realistic trade that I see happening is Russell Westbrook to the Miami Heat. Now, I know that a lot of people will probably hate on this one because I am a Miami Heat fan, but I'm not being biased at all, and I do believe that this is the number one target and the number one team that Russell Westbrook can land up on. This is why. Number one, Russell Westbrook wants to play for a contending team. Because of Westbrook's services to the Oklahoma City Thunder and what he's done for that team, they will only trade him to a contending team. They wouldn't do him dirty, even though they have the ability to trade him to any team. And obviously, the Miami Heat just got Jimmy Butler. And we all know about Pat Riley and his ambitions to get star players together and compete. And when you think about it, the Miami Heat, they're going to have a max spot in next year's free agency. But the free agency next year is not that good. If Russell Westbrook was in next year's free agency, in my opinion, he would be the top free agent to get. But what would the trade look like? Well, in my opinion, the Oklahoma City Thunder, because of Russell Westbrook's huge contract, they can't do a lot and they won't expect a lot simply because of his huge contract. Russell Westbrook heads to Miami and Miami gives up Derrick Jones Jr. or Justice Winslow, and I don't believe they're going to give up Bam Adebayo or Tyler Hero. So let's say they give up Justice Winslow. Justice Winslow, Goran Dragic, and probably a guy like Kelly Olynyk or James Johnson to make the contract situation work out. And I honestly do not think that Miami will give up a pick. And if they do, it will just be one pick. Because honestly, Miami doesn't even have many first round picks to give up. And I don't think Pat Riley would be willing to give up another one, considering the Thunder already have Miami's 2021 first round pick and 2023 first round pick. As much as it would hurt losing Justice Winslow, I think getting Russell Westbrook would make up for it, but that would be really tough. If I'm Pat Riley, I'm doing my all to make that package. Derrick Jones Jr., who's still a very young prospect who's shown potential. Kelly Olynyk, who is off the books next season, but it makes the contract situation work out. Goran Dragic, who is also off the books next season, but once again, makes the contract situation work out. And one future first round pick. But the only other trade proposal I see happening is possibly if the Thunder also throw in Steven Adams, Miami may also throw in Bam Adebayo, which means the Miami Heat would have Russell Westbrook, Jimmy Butler, Justice Winslow, and Steven Adams, which is still a very good team in the Eastern Conference. But as a Heat fan, I would much rather we keep Bam and just take on Russell Westbrook for Goran Dragic, Derrick Jones Jr., a future first round pick, and either Kelly Olynyk or James Johnson. With that being said, the other team I have as an honorable mention is the Los Angeles Lakers. Do I think they're going to get Russell Westbrook and do I think they have the chance? Probably not, simply due to the contract situation. But the Lakers have a very strong case to get Russell Westbrook, and I've stated it before, Russell Westbrook is from LA, number one. Russell Westbrook played in UCLA, number two. Russell Westbrook wants to play in a contending team, number three. And number four, Russell Westbrook and LeBron James have been spending a lot of time together, and it wouldn't surprise me if that happened. The only thing that would prevent this from going through would be obviously the contract situation, but the Lakers could give up Kyle Kuzma, Danny Green, and probably a few other pieces that are on one-year contracts plus future first-round picks. And I just think if you're the Lakers and you're going to lose some depth, I don't think it's worth it. But at the same time, if they really are not doing that well at the trade deadline, LeBron James can pull something out of nothing if Russell Westbrook is still on the Thunder at that time. And with that being said, let me know where you guys think that Russell Westbrook will end up. Let's see if we can reach 2,000 likes for the next video. Subscribe if you're new. Be sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss a video. And also be sure to follow me on Instagram. With that said, hope you guys enjoyed the video. I am out. Peace.